200 days of Trump. Last night, the president complained the fake news refuses to report the success of the first 6 months. Supreme Court, surging economy and jobs, border and military security, ISIS and MS-13, etc. So let's take a little walk down those suggestions and test them. President Trump did get his pick on the Supreme Court, Justice Neil Gorsuch. The economy, the Dow is in record territory. Unemployment at 4.3% with 1 million jobs created under President Trump. But with 6 years and 10 months of consecutive job growth, most of those years were under President Obama. So this is a continuation more than it is a new trend since President Trump took office. More recently, the dollar is at a 14-month low. Average wages are still stagnant. And remember, that's what matters most. That's what President Trump kept saying during the campaign. It's not about the unemployment rate, it's about wages, and that those are still underwater. Border arrests are down about 14%, but the question becomes why? Is it intimidation by President Trump, or is it surrounding economic externalities to that policy discussion, meaning that Mexico has an improving economy? It means a lot of people don't need to come to the United States for opportunity. Now, MS-13, the administration points to the arrest of 39 suspected MS-13 gang members in New York, and there's certainly increased emphasis on them. ISIS, the State Department claims one-third of territory reclaimed from ISIS was taken in the past 6 months and credits Trump military policy. Problem is with that, you talk to military experts, they're going to tell you that it's hard to prove that assumption. So that's what the president celebrates, but what about his other big campaign promises?
We will be able to immediately repeal and replace Obamacare.
My number one priority is to dismantle the disastrous deal with Iran.
We will build a great wall along the southern border.
Well, look, let's be honest. The big ticket items haven't happened. You know very well the latest attempt at health care reform is dead in the water. The Iran nuclear deal is still in place, and many experts will say that's a good thing. The wall, we just heard what happened in those transcripts with the President of the United States and the President of Mexico. He was calling it a political stunt at that point. Will it happen? We don't know, but it could be central to this upcoming debt ceiling fight. All right, so there's a take on the plus minus for these 200 days. Let's talk about President Trump's promises and what he has delivered on with CNN senior economics analyst Stephen Moore. He was the senior economic advisor to President Trump's campaign and is now a distinguished visiting fellow at the Heritage Foundation. And we have Brian Lanza. He was deputy communications director for the Trump campaign. It's good to see you both. The president, if he's watching this morning, cannot complain that we have a stacked panel. It is all Trump folk here this morning. So let's start with the political optics. Brian Lanza, what do you believe the president has a right to celebrate 200 days in?
Yeah, I would say he has consumer confidence. I think if you look at, you know, the sort of culture that the president brings to Washington, is he's brought a culture of business. He's brought a laser focus on jobs. And that laser focus, whether it's deregulation, whether it's, you know, the stock market hitting 30 new highs in the first 6 months, that focus has been jobs. And I think that's something the president can hang his hat on and say that the voters voted a president who wanted to focus on jobs, and they certainly have that.
And the pushback, Stephen, is the data is there. You can't argue with the numbers, but you can argue on their source. Most of these positive space data metrics are continuations. And while there may be, as Brian suggests, a rhetorical emphasis on jobs, he hasn't made any hard actions that have changed the labor base or certainly the wage structure.
Well, there's a lot there. Let me start with this idea that this is a continuation. I mean, certainly we have had an eight-year expansion. That's undeniable, Chris. But, you know, if you look at last year, 2016, the economy grew at 1.5%. A lot of people said we were headed towards a recession, that this recovery had run out of gas. And same thing with the bull market. And in fact, instead of the deceleration that we had seen in 2016, the economy actually has gotten better. It's actually ramped up into a higher gear. The same thing with the stock market. I mean, look, there's no denying that the stock market rose 700 points the day after the election. Investors and employers really like what Trump is doing. Just one other quick point I would make. It is true, obviously, the sore thumb that you you mentioned, Chris, is that they've gotten nowhere on Obamacare, and that's a big embarrassment to the Republican Party, no question about it. But on the regulatory front, when I talk to businessmen and women who are running companies, they say just the easing of the regulations has really been a plus for their businesses and their hiring.
Brian, the big ticket items, whether it is what Stephen was just referring to with how to make health care better, big tax reform, big infrastructure, big wall, not done. What level of criticism does that warrant?
You know, I think it's a wait and see. I mean, let's have some perspective here. You have, you know, health care. We came up one vote short. The president and the Republicans came up one vote short. None of them are stopping. They're going to continue. I think, you know, we both know, having served in government myself a good number of years, it's a slow process. It is a sausage-making factory, and it's never a pretty process. You know, look at when Obama passed Obamacare. He had to hand out gifts to several U.S. senators just to get it on, you know, just to get the vote going forward. We're 6 months into this. I'm very comfortable with it being a slow process. I'm comfortable with the president putting a good focus on it, challenging Republicans to stay true to their campaign promises. And, you know, we'll go from there. I mean, it is, you know, government inherently is a slow process. I wish it would have happened faster, but it's not. But I also like the fact that he's still focused on it. He's still rallying the troops. You know, if you look at some of the other issues, you know, Stephen brought up, you know, the economy, you know, deregulation. The last 6 months of the Obama administration, he passed $600 billion of regulatory burdens on new businesses. President Trump has passed zero regulatory burdens on new businesses. Like I said, it's very much about a culture change here in Washington, D.C., that America's open for business again.
I think that's true, Chris. I would simply...
Go ahead, but hold on. Let me recast it a second, though, because I want to attack the premise, and you can give us the conclusion. No, I mean, look, the job is to test, my friend. If I just let you give your version of events, there's really no reason for the show. So, Stephen, although you guys have your own show now to do that. So let's try and balance it out here with a little bit of fact and not just feelings about things. So, Stephen, the idea of... what Brian was just saying, which is, you know, we're moving in the right direction, we're doing these things, but is that enough on these things? You know, whether it's getting health care done, he couldn't come up with enough goodies to get the Republicans to want to do the right thing by his perspective. So how much of the lack of action on the big ticket items must you blame on a lack of leadership to this point?
Well, it's a good question. Look, I just was in Nashville this weekend at a political rally, and I got to tell you, you know, the attitude in Washington, D.C. and New York and maybe Silicon Valley is, you know, Trump is a disaster, he's a failure. But when you go out and talk to the people, you know, out in the real America, they're excited by Trump.
But there are people who are at a Trump rally, Stephen.
Well, look,
I mean, of course they're going to be pumped up. Look at the poll numbers. You can't find a group within your own party where he's growing.
Okay,
at this point.
So that's a fair point. So let me address your point about what Trump has to do. Look, the failure of Obamacare repeal, and by the way, I don't think that fight is over, was a big, big, big setback. There's no question about that. And it only doubles down, Chris, in my opinion, what he has to do next, which is the Republicans have to deliver. They must deliver on tax reduction and tax reform this fall. If they don't, then I'll be attacking, you know, the Republicans and the president, because this is one of the central promises that Trump signed. I always said he had to do three things this year. He had to get health care, Obamacare repealed, he had to get a tax cut, and he had to build the wall. And by the way, I think you're being excessively negative on the wall. The wall is being built right now, Chris, on the southern border. I've been down there. They're building that wall.
Well, but look, this comes down to semantics. I mean, I've also been down to the border. I know what's going on. I've been listening to Will Hurd, one of the bright lights in your party. And the idea that the wall that the president promised is already underway is just not
accurate. It is.
Accurate.
Well, I was down there. I mean, I've seen it.
They're doing construction, but they're not doing what he suggested that they would. The money hasn't been there. The impetus isn't there. Might it be? Maybe. But I think at a minimum, you have to say the jury's out on whether or not that promise is going to be delivered as argued.
Well, Chris, it'd be nice if we get a single Democrat to vote for the money for the wall. I mean, come on. I mean, the Democrats basically have been opposed to appropriating virtually any money for
building
that wall.
But you got to pick your position. Either the wall is underway or it's not underway because the Democrats are fighting it. You've learned the doublespeak very well, very quickly here on TV, Stephen Moore. I appreciate you doing it. Always value added.
We're spending the money that the Congress has allowed us to spend.
All right. And how you're doing it and how much of it is new construction versus pre-existing plans is a whole discussion we could have. I don't want to have it with you, though. You're too smart. Brian Lanza, it's great to add you to the mix. Always welcome
here
on New Day.
Thanks, Chris. Have a great day.
All right. Brianna, over to you.